Chamber pressure is nominal.
T-plus 43 seconds into the test flight of the inaugural Starship vehicle. Tower cleared, we're into pitch over. Propulsion reports first stage engines nominal. What a sight when the ground cameras at starboard. We're flying at twice the thrust of the Saturn V heading to space.
Additional signal, this is Christie.
We're throttled down and throttled back up. Going through the period of maximum aerodynamic pressure. As the velocity increases, the density of the atmosphere is decreasing.
Max Q.
Lessening stress on the vehicle. The call out, Max Q now. Continuing to watch the first stage as we head downrange. A 100 seconds into flight. Our next major activity is going to be shutdown of the first stage. The Houston Tracking Station now acquiring the vehicle. With shutdown, we will get separation of Starship and Super Heavy and ignition of the Starship engines. When Starship separates, we light up 6 engines in a staggered sequence. If all goes well, those 6 engines will burn for almost 6.5 minutes. Onboard view from Starship. And there's views of the Raptor engines on the second stage as we prepare for stage separation. Now after stage separation, the first stage will flip and begin a boost back maneuver for landing in the Gulf. Continuing to fly, 2 minutes, 40 seconds. Let's get ready for main engine cutoff.
Booster engine cutoff.
Beginning the flip for stage separation.
As of right now, we are awaiting stage separation, where Starship should separate from the Super Heavy booster.
Yeah, Kate, right now it looks like we saw the start of the flip, but obviously we're seeing from the ground cameras the entire Starship stack continuing to rotate. We should have had separation by now. Obviously, this does not appear to be a nominal situation.
Yeah, it does appear to be spinning, but I do want to remind everyone that everything after clearing the tower was icing on the cake. And there, as you saw, as we promised, an exciting end to the Starship inaugural integrated test flight.